the church celebrates the feast of the dedication of Saint John Lateran, considered to be the mother and mistress of all the churches in the city and in the world, for being the episcopal seat of the Pope as Bishop of Rome, it ranks even above Saint Peter's. Fausta, the consort of Constantine the Great, gave her Lateran Palace to Pope Saint Miltiades in about 313, and on the 9th of November 324, Pope Saint Sylvester I solemnly consecrated part of it as the Basilica of the Most Holy Savior, the first instance of a public consecration of a church. The ceremony was in all probability a relatively simple one, but the elaborate ritual with which a church is solemnly dedicated today was known to have already been in use in the 9th century. What remained of the palace served as a residence for the popes over the next 1,000 years, and today serves as a museum. Between the 4th and 16th centuries, 5 ecumenical councils and 20 synods were held in this basilica. Since the 12th century, it has been known as Saint John Lateran, in honor of Saints John the Baptist and John the Evangelist. In fact, the Lateran was then to the Catholic world what the Vatican is today, the seat of judgment and the center of government in the church. The original structure and its successors have suffered the ravages of war, earthquake and fire. The full Baroque remodeling and decoration of the present structure was executed by Francesco Borromini under Pope Innocent X in the year 1646. One of Rome's most imposing churches, St. John's, has a towering facade built by Alexander Galilei in the year 1735, crowned with 15 colossal statues that include one each of Christ, John the Baptist, John the Evangelist, and the 12 doctors of the church. Among the outstanding relics which are preserved in this great shrine of Christendom are said to be the heads of Saint Peter and Paul encased in silver busts. Beneath the high altar rest remnants of the little wooden table on which Saint Peter used to celebrate Mass in the House of Pudens, and the sacred table of the Last Supper of our Lord.